Hello student, welcome in biology booster. This is me, Ravi sir. This lecture is for class 9th and the chapter first is cell as a basic unit of life. Now here it begin. In this part, this is the first part, and in first part we cover some topic like number one, definition of the cell, second is discovery of cell, third one is cell theory, then size of the cell, shape of the cell, type of the cell, and the last one is difference between plant and animal cell. So come to the first topic, definitions of cell. As we know that from in class 6, cell, there are so many cells are combined together to form tissue. Tissue are combined to form organ. Organ are combined to form organ system, and later it be converted into the organism. So we can define it as cell is the basic structural and functional unit of any organism. Here we can show that cell, tissue, organ, organ system, and one is organism. Get back to the next topic, that is discovery of cell. The first name that will come in the discovery of cell, that is Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke, he discovered cell in 1665. He was the first scientist who developed their own microscope with the help of two lenses with a high magnification power. Basically, they are the compound microscope. Okay. Next one, he was discovering cell while studying he was studying very slice piece of the cork or bark or phloem on the stem of any plant, especially the mango tree. There is the outer part is called as cork, bark or phloem. It is a non-living part of the plant. So when he just saw a cell wall, and that is the dead cell. At that time he wrote a book that is Micrographia, and write all his experiment about the cell in it. The term cell was given by him. The second one is first you see that Robert Hooke, this is the microscope that he will use in that, and this one is the diagram. Second name, that is Antoni von Leeuwenhoek. See, or discovered a living cell in pond water. He used compound microscope with a high magnification power. At that time he discovered many of the microorganism or cell with the help of this microscope. So he is called as father of microscopy. He contributed his work in the discovery of so many things in microbiology, so he was also called as father of microbiology. This one is Antoni von Leeuwenhoek and the microscope that he will use. Now come back to the cell theory. Cell theory is basically given by two scientists, that is Sweden and next one is Swan. Basically the cell theory had contributed of 3 points. The two points was given by Sweden and Swan, and the third point is most important point is given by Rodolphe Virchow. Now here is the first point. All the living organism, whether it was plant or animal, are made up of cell, whether it was unicell or multicell, whether it was unicellular or multicellular. Next one is the simple definition of the cell, that is cell is the basic structure and functional unit of any living organism. Third and most important point that is given by the Rodolphe Virchow is called, that is omnicellular e-cellula, means each and every cell arise from his pre-existing cell. You can see that here, this diagram, you see that one cell are split into the two cell. In this way, two cells are originated. Now there are so many exceptions in the cell theory. The first one is virus, because virus is not living or non-living, it is a connecting link between living and non-living, so cell theory will be not applicable for this. The two more is that chloroplast and mitochondria, these are the two cell organelles which are present in the cell, whether it was plant cell or animal cell or in both. They have their own DNA, so it can be easily replicate itself. Come to the size of the cell. Size totally varies. Some of the cells which can be easily seen with the help of naked eye, but some of them are so minute which cannot be easily seen. It will be seen with the help of microscope. The smallest cell that today is known, that is PPLO, that is pleuropneumonia like organism, commonly called as mycoplasma. This is the diagram. Second one is the largest cell, that is ostrich egg, as we all know. This is the diagram. Third one is the longest cell, that is nerve cell, which are present in our body, help in stimulus. Next, shape of the cell. There is no fix the shape of the cell. Cell may be regular or irregular. Irregular means that is amoeba, because its shape is not fixed, and there are so many shapes are regular. The shape is depend on the two factors, that is external and internal pressure and function performed by the cell. There are so many cells. You can see the muscle cell, blood cell, nerve cell, sperm cell, skin cell. Their shapes are different. Now come to the type of the cell. Basically the cells are two types. Number one is prokaryotic and number two is eukaryotic. In prokaryotic, we have to know about the two example, that is bacteria and archaebacteria. And eukaryotic, basically we will learn about the plant and animal cell. Now, this is number one, prokaryotic cell. Pro and karyotic. Pro, that is primitive. Primitive, it means old. Karyon, any nucleus. Study of nucleus is called karyology. Please be reminded. These are the cells are primitive nucleus, which are called as nucleoid or incipient nucleus. In this nucleus, nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope is absent. Okay, all the cell membrane bound organelles, just like chloroplast, mitochondria, all any cell organelles are absent. Example, bacteria, blue-green alga, mycoplasma. This is the diagram of bacteria. Next one is eukaryotic cell. Eu means true, karyon, a nucleus. In this, nucleus is well developed because nucleus is enclosed or covered with the nuclear membrane. A large number of cell membrane bound organelles are present in that. They are larger in size. Cell wall is present only in the plant cell, not in the animal cell. And in plant cell, the cell wall is made up of cellulose. Next one example, that is all plant and animal cell. So you see that plant cell first. This is the diagram of plant cell. There are so many that first you see that the vacuole. You see that nucleus is not present in the center in plant cell because due to the presence of large vacuole. Okay, so the question will arise that why nucleus is not present in the center in plant cell, because due to the presence of large vacuole. Okay, now come, this one is the animal cell. Animal cell, you see that nucleus is present in the center because vacuole is small or absent. Okay, because there is no need of that. Difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell, you can see that there are so many differences between diameter of the cell. You see that there are so many differences. Prokaryotic cell, there are basically very small. Eukaryotic cell are big. Nucleus, already told you that about that membrane enclosed organelles basically absent, and eukaryotic cell it was present. Flagella is present in prokaryotic cell, but in the complex one is present in the eukaryotic cell. Cell wall, that is in prokaryotic cell it is called as capsule. Okay, and in that is it is called a simpler one. There are so many one, plasma membrane, okay, cytoplasm, no cytoskeleton, and in that eukaryotic cytoplasm is present. Ribosome is smaller in size, eukaryotic in larger in size. Cell division is take place in the simple way, yani asexual reproduction will take place in prokaryotic cells, especially the binary fission. But in eukaryotic cell, mitosis and meiosis is also take place. Sexual reproduction, only the DNA transformation is take place. And this one is meiosis. Difference between plant and animal cell. This one is most important. The diagram, you have to draw the diagram like this. you see that this one is the easy way you have to learn about the difference between plant and animal cell. In plant cell, you see that chloroplast cell wall, one large central vacuole nucleus is usually pushed to the side, rectangular shape are present, whereas in animal cell, lysosome nucleus is usually in the center, round shape, many small vacuoles are present. But what are common in that too, that is endoplasmic reticulum, that is both rough and smooth, mitochondria, ribosome, vacuole, Golgi apparatus, nuclear membrane, cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. These are the common cell organelles which are present in between that too, that is plant and animal cell. Next one, you see the difference between plant and animal cell. In various examination, maximum 4 or 5 you have to write the difference in between the plant and animal cell. This is the end of part 1. Thank you. Stay home and keep learning.